What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Steve.
I'm Lindsay.
Today we're going to be riding to Brookwood, the UK's largest Commonwealth War Graves Cemetery. This video has been on my list for quite some time now. Had a lot of people ask us to check into this cemetery. Don't know anything about it beyond the fact that it is a war grave cemetery.
I don't think I've ever heard the term war grave cemetery.
I don't know if I have heard that term before. It's not familiar to me, but I don't know how else you would describe what this probably is.
Is this, I guess my question is, this is an actual burial ground cemetery, or is this like this is where bodies are?
Yeah.
Not just like a memorial, names.
No. I mean, obviously we see the headstones here.
Yeah, but I didn't know if it was like markers just with names showing.
Oh,
like an honor
I see what you're saying. No, let us know in the comments, guys, but I'm guessing this is actually a burial ground.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think this is just a memorial place. I think this is an actual cemetery. I guess
if it has the word cemetery.
Yeah, I think it would be called some kind of memorial grounds or something like that if it wasn't. So, yeah, I'm sure this is an actual, cemetery. Yeah, but yeah, guys, enough rambling from us. Let's go ahead and dive in here and check out the Brookwood Cemetery, the UK's largest Commonwealth War Graves Cemetery.
Oh, that's beautiful. Is that a sword?
I think it is, yeah. And a cross?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. It's beautiful grounds.
Yeah, I was going to say that it's really well kept.
Every year, huge numbers of people visit the war cemeteries of Flanders, Normandy, and other overseas battle sites to pay their respects to the servicemen and women who fell during two world wars.
No.
But this isn't one of them. Brookwood Military Cemetery, near Woking in Surrey, is the largest Commonwealth War Cemetery in the United Kingdom. Set alongside a vast civilian burial site, it is a final resting place for thousands of military personnel.
Yeah, I've heard that Brookwood Cemetery itself is huge, so this must be...
It looks big.
Well, this is like just the war grave section. There's an actual...
Wow. So it's not just...
No,
military.
I don't think so.
There's other...
If I'm not mistaken, because there is a Brookwood Cemetery I've been asked to react to as well. And so I'm guessing this is like just a part of it. And supposedly Brookwood is huge.
It looks beautiful.
From Australia, Canada, India, New Zealand, South Africa, as well as the UK and Ireland.
Wow.
Located near a train line, it met the need for the many casualties of the First World War who died in London. And it was later extended during the Second World War.
Mm.
Brookwood Military Cemetery came about as a portion of Brookwood Civilian Cemetery, and in 1917, the first service personnel of the British Empire were buried here.
1917?
And now we have over 8,000 members of British and Empire Commonwealth units commemorated here at the site. About 5,000 of them are buried, and more than 3,000 of them are named on two memorials here.
Wow.
As you may hear, there's a train line. You may hear trains in the background, and that's because this is on the main line to London, which is why a cemetery was built here to start with. It's a very convenient way of dealing with bodies that you need to bring in from town and bury them from a special station that was built just for that.
Oh, wow. Is that the, what was it called? There's some sort of, like, I remember hearing about that, and it's something I want to check out at some point. It was like a London... line that was specifically to bring bodies to a cemetery. I didn't know.
It must have been this.
Yeah. So Brookwood must be that main cemetery that had to do with that line. Let me know in the comments, guys, what that was called. I can't remember exactly what that was called. I'm sure people know what we're talking about here. But yeah, that obviously would be a convenient way to bring bodies in 1917, 1920.
Maybe they'll address this, but I'm just confused. It's like people from all the Commonwealth countries, basically.
I mean, a lot of them.
Not all
like.
Of them, but not just the UK.
Right, yeah.
And so were these soldiers like fighting in World War I and World War II, and they were there in the UK, and that's why they're buried there?
I'm not sure. I believe so, because I can't imagine they would have brought their bodies right. in from other right. other countries yeah. to be buried here. I'm guessing these are the fallen from
British soil.
Specifically, okay. she said the London area. Mm-hmm. And so let us know in the comments, guys, but I'm pretty sure that most of these fell in like the London area or something like that, which is insane when you think about that. How many? There's 5,000 buried here.
And then an additional 3,000.
Memorialized.
In name.
Yeah.
Brookwood honors there all it is. Fallen military personnel. In vast plots across its 37 acres lie sailors, soldiers, Air Force men and women, lost in numerous conflicts from Flanders to Afghanistan. And they range from nationality to age.
Hold on, guys.
From Chelsea pensioners to a 15-year-old South African soldier.
Oh, wow.
Influenza.
Oh, man, that's sad.
1918 at age 15, wow.
So, they said Afghanistan.
Yeah.
And I saw 2009. So, they're
so
still...
So, it's not just World War One and World War II.
I didn't know this would be a working cemetery still. Like
still people active. Being buried there, yeah.
Wow. I thought this cemetery was, you know, people were done being buried here just from World War One, maybe World War Two.
Yeah, that's what I thought too.
So, wow. So, they're still using this.
I wonder, it wouldn't be every person killed in action.
Right? No, I doubt it, but this
so
is...
So I wonder what the like yeah. qualifications are to be buried there.
Yeah, I do. I don't know.
Maintained by the Commonwealth War Graves Commission,
wow.
its white headstones are laid out in straight rows representing soldiers on parade. And its horticultural
oh, wow.
design
okay, I get
and flower
that.
Schemes, recalling an English garden... follow established principles found across the commission's cemeteries.
It looks very it meticulously kept.
Yeah.
That the sites we maintain are beautiful, fitting, permanent resting places and places for reflection for the people who died, but really for those who come still to remember them today, whether they knew
wow.
them personally or not.
Okay.
That's amazing.
I don't mean to keep on pausing, guys, but I just want to say that I don't know if I've ever seen...
such...
It's very interesting how they've, like, most cemeteries have, like, a single place for a flower in front of a tombstone or something like that. I love the way this is,
like integrated.
There's these rows mm-hmm. where the graves yeah. are, and they have this whole, like, English garden-type
yeah.
look on in row form like that. I really
it
like that.
It just seems very respectful, like, mm-hmm. very attentive to detail, meticulously kept. Like, it's just an... very honorable thing.
Yeah, I think this is beautiful.
So the plants we use in front of the headstone are called anti-splash plants. It's not a botanical name, it's a name given because when the rain hits the headstone, the rain bounces off the headstone, it hits the border, the dirt in the border. That then will splash back up onto the headstone. Hmm. The placing of dot plants are placed every
oh.
8 headstones. So if we start with this one, this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, repeated.
Not all the dead have headstones. Opened by the Queen in 1958, the Brookwood Memorial commemorates the men and women who died during the Second World War and have no known grave.
Mm.
Some were members of SOE, the Special Operations Executive, and their names are carved on panels of green slate.
One of the members of the SOE that we commemorate by name here in Brookwood is a woman called Violette Szabo. She chose very bravely to volunteer with the SOE and to go into France to do secret agent work.
Wow.
She went on one mission, it was very successful. She came home, they asked her to go again. She agreed to go again. This is in the aftermath of the June landings in 1944. And unfortunately on that mission, she was taken prisoner. She She was in captivity for months, and they murdered her at a concentration camp in January 1945, thinking that they would erase all trace of her from the world. But because of our memorial, they have not.
Wow.
Now that is beautiful.
Within the grounds lies the Brookwood American Cemetery and Memorial. Its First World War graves and Chapel of the Missing are managed by the American Battle Monuments Commission.
Wow.
I can understand coming from the outside, and you look at what we do and how we maintain the site, and you do come to us and say, why? Well, why not? These men and women had a short life. And in that short span of life, they gave us something which is beautiful. They gave us our liberty, our freedom.
Wow.
I'm not trying to thump my chest over the story, but it's the least you can do for them is take care of them and remember what they did.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting to cry on this video. Ugh, it's like the epitome of gone but not forgotten, you know?
Yeah.
Wow. Ugh, I gotta get a tissue.
They had their whole lives ahead of them.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave up their lives in the name of freedom.
Yeah.
You know, so many of these soldiers were 17, 18, 19. One is young as 15 years old, which is insane. They're, again, kids. That's the thing that always, you know, that's the thing that always gets me with these types of videos, with the war type stuff, is just how young. I think a lot of us forget, like, these are just kids. They were going into battle.
Yeah.
Like, it's just, it's insane when you really think of it like that. It's just, it's sad.
It is sad. But it's beautiful that they're honored and remembered in this way. And I don't know that I've ever seen, I mean, granted, I haven't looked at a lot of
this
cemeteries
type of stuff,
like this, but it just seems like the most well-kept, attentive to details cemetery, memorial cemetery I've ever seen.
Like, right.
They take it very seriously.
It's beautiful. Yeah. Yes.
This marble is the same marble that was used in the quarries, with the same ones used by Michelangelo, his Pietà, his David. It is just fascinating. It's easy to work with, so it was easy to engrave, sturdy, stable, durability, and you can cut into it without damaging. And it's not inexpensive.
It's so beautiful. Look at this.
It
so
doesn't really
beautiful.
Matter what the price is. What matters is the honor for the guys that are here. So,
hold on, guys. I just got to take a look at this. Like, this is just like seeing this just such well manicured lawn with these crosses and this building right here in the back. It's just beautiful.
Did they say this specific part
is American,
World War
One? I said American. I'm not sure if it was just World War One or not, but I didn't know they actually had an American section in this. Mm-hmm. I thought it was the Commonwealth only.
You want to give them the best, and in many cases, cut out is considered the best there is.
Located nearby are French, Polish, Belgian, and Italian sections, as well as a plot for Czech RAF crews lost in several crashes over the United Kingdom.
For me personally, when you come to somewhere like Brookwood, which is so beautiful and so peaceful, what astounds me is how young these men were, how far away from home they were, how passionate they were to fight for freedom for their families, and that the fear that they faced every day going up in those planes or in those bombers, you know, at such a young age, I can't imagine it. It's incredible, and I respect and admire them enormously. But I also give thanks for the peace that I stand in here, because it's down to what they did that allows me to do that.
During the Cold War, exiled soldiers from Eastern Europe were often neglected by their home countries. But now their achievements can be recalled with pride.
Their stories were actually wiped out of history books and wiped out of the records, and they're only now coming to find out about the veterans. So we're working hard in Slovakia and Czech Republic to tell the story there.
That's
not
beautiful.
Just here in the UK.
Sad
during the Second World
they
War,
were
when playing the last post was banned by the Germans at the Ypres Menin Gate Memorial, the event was taken up at Brookwood and has continued ever since.
I will shortly recite the Kaddish, the traditional Jewish prayer in memory of the departed. El Malei Rachamim, God who art full of mercy, the word mercy being the same in Hebrew and Arabic, it's rather nice. Yes Koret Nishmatot, remember the souls.
Today's service is multi-faith, as are the many sailors, soldiers, airmen and women buried in Brookwood.
We have a number of different faiths come along, and it's just basically saying that when it comes to war dead, it crosses all divides.
Today, new groups of pilgrims are discovering this site and are coming to pay their respects. Three friends from the West Country have encouraged other bikers to visit.
The West Country.
A few of us got together and we just essentially thought we wanted to do a bit of an event.
Ride to remember.
To pay a bit of respect, yeah. And to remember our servicemen and women. We're very conscious the bikers do a lot for charity and do a lot of fundraising, and we thought, wouldn't it be nice just to have a free event that's just about paying respect?
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures.
You just don't know what to expect until you've actually sort of walked around it. And as I say, it just brings out all sorts of emotions.
Yeah, about seeing it in person.
Yeah.
I work in a school, and to have a 15-year-old South African that died, albeit not in being killed in the war, but having been serving at 15, that's younger than some of the kids I've got at my school. So it really did kind of strike a chord, and yeah.
That's insane, I'm not emotional, man.
But tears to the eye kind of moment.
How does that happen? Like, I know it was a different time back, you know, World War I, World War II even, but like, how does someone at 15 years old, you know, get enlisted in their nation to go fight? I mean, did they lie about their age? Were they allowed to in certain nations
probably
to go that
allowed.
Young? That's wild. You know, like, I mean, I know that, you know, here in the U.S., they would go as early as 17. And I'm probably, honestly had some soldiers probably got in earlier than that somehow.
Yeah.
Which is just, it's so sad.
Yeah.
You know, it's just so sad that all these young men, you know, fought and died, you know, like this. Just, I mean, I hate war. I hate war. I wish war wasn't a thing, but unfortunately it is. And at least this is honoring these people.
Not in vain.
Yeah.
Brookwood Military Cemetery is notable for its peacefulness and tranquility, but it has sometimes been overlooked. The Commonwealth War Graves Commission hopes that more people will remember the many thousands who rest here in England and recall their courage and sacrifice.
Is remembrance going to drop off slowly? Do people need to be more aware of this place? Do they need to come here and visit? Yes, it's a fascinating place. And these guys that you see out here, you know, they gave their lives for us, and they'll be here tomorrow and here every day, sadly. And, you know, we need to come and pay our respects.
For the Commonwealth War Graves Commission, we exist to remember. But I would say we do this on behalf of society, of everybody. And really, we exist so that they can remember, so that they can come to our sites and see the men and women that we commemorate and do the work of remembering themselves.
Wow.
That's beautiful.
This is an incredible place, guys.
Yeah.
You know, and what that man was saying is so true, that if we don't have places like this and bring attention to places like this, the next generations and the generations that follow will slowly forget,
mm-hmm.
you know, the sacrifices of these people, of these men.
And
the,
why it happened,
the wars in general. This stuff over time, it does have a tendency to get forgotten. And,
yeah, because it didn't happen to our generations. So, I mean, unless you're being taught about it or it's brought to your attention, then you're not going to know. And
you know, a good example of that is us and our generations. While sure, like, you know, we were briefly taught about, you know, World War II, I was taught very little about World War I. And I'm guessing my parents' generations probably knew a lot more about World War I.
Yeah.
But how much did they know about the Civil War, for example, here in the U.S.? That's just an example. Like, it just goes to show you, each generation loses bits and pieces of the past unless it is brought to their attention. And, you know, unfortunately, we can't learn everything about every war and every issue, right? But, you know, stuff like this, it's beautiful to have memorials like this. if for no other reason than to bring attention to the sacrifice these young men, and it sounds like at least a woman is memorialized here as well, yeah, did for, you know, freedom.
I'm really glad we checked this out today.
Yeah, me too.
I didn't know what to expect or even really what... I mean, I can gather by the name. Obviously, it's in honor of fallen soldiers, but, you know, I've never seen anything like this in person. So, to see... Even in video, really.
Right. And to I didn't think you'd seen something like this. And I really personally haven't looked into much stuff like this, but I find it fascinating. I'd like to look into more, like, war cemeteries.
And visit them in person.
Yes, I would definitely visit this place when we go over there. We would. But I love cemeteries in general.
I do, too.
This, you know, something like a war grave cemetery is a little bit more special, obviously. But cemeteries in general, I just love them, guys. So... let us know in the comments, guys, what we should check out next in terms of whether it's a wartime cemetery, something else to do with battle and war and, you know, so forth and so on. Or even if it's just a really cool, beautiful cemetery, just a normal cemetery we check out. Because I think we both love that sort of thing quite a bit. So be something we'd be interested in checking out. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Please click that like button. Feel free to drop your comments or suggestions about this video or others. And don't forget to subscribe to continue to follow us on our journey to discover anything and everything about the UK and Ireland. Until next time, guys. Peace.
Bye.